I initially started with a sketch about this size, just an 11 by 17, where I'd worked out the main figures that I thought might comprise the wall, because I hadn't gotten a full measurement of the wall early on. So I had no idea what amount of space I was going to fill. And I figured if I had to boil it down, all the Marvel characters to like who are the most classic versions that you would group together, this is what I tried to get past them. I figured I'd throw in enough of the new X-Men that they'd feel like I was, you know, giving enough acknowledgement of, hey, who's the hip modern characters, when in fact they're 45 years old. But I could throw in things like the Vision, Scarlet Witch, and really cheat in, say, like the classic Spider-Woman costume that they weren't using anymore at that point, figuring that they just sort of slide that past them. But what would happen then is I would get the information about the real length of the wall, which would turn out to be about double this width. So I then figured out how to expand that with more characters so that on both ends, I was creating artwork that would expand it even further. And even on this side here, as much as I added these six figures to expand it out this way, I still figured out another couple of ways to squeeze in, like I'm putting in Ghost Rider on his motorbike that's gonna be half cropped out of the frame, but like he's in here, and then Shang-Chi, I'm squeezing him in here, so that at least I have that character who's normally never in these kind of groupings, but you know, I'm getting him thrown in there. And on the other side of the piece, I'm expanding it out to include the original X-Men all grouping together here, which I love doing that, and including Cap's partner Falcon in his classic appearance, throwing in a couple of the Inhumans, and Hawkeye, and ending with Punisher. More or less every character that you see here is of Marvel characters that were created between 1961 and 1980. So, the last of which new characters, I think, would be probably She-Hulk, who was created in 1980. So, I also did a marker comp of just coloring in over the Xeroxes of showing how the shadow placement in the paintings is going to be very striking. So, when you're finally seeing it in color, it doesn't feel as dark or as grim necessarily, but this gives you a strong sense of light and shadow. Which that was the purpose of this sketch. And then I did do a color sketch on the copies so that I could show them fully. Here's what the final thing will look like. It was all assembled in one file, and that they approved, and then I was off to the races.